In this video, we would like to talk about how to make passage plan on Transas Navisailor 4000 Actis. Here we can make passage plan in two different ways. Either we can make it from task list and go to route planning. From the route planning, we can also make passage plan. Also, we can make it from the Navy Planner. Normally, I prefer making in the Navy Planner because this one is more user friendly for me. So that I show the Navy Planner first. After that, I will show you from the route planning. So let's go to Navy Planner. Click on the Navy Planner button. Either we can make a new route. For your information, normally we make a route from berth to berth. For your time consumption, today I will show you some route which we already make. So I will describe over that so that it will be more easy to understand. So let's go to a route first. From route, we load a route from the load option. Click on the load option and let's say we go to Tawau to Singapore. Okay, Tawau to Singapore AWPA in use. This rename it. If you want to keep this route and also make another new route, you can rename it so that the previous route will be there. If you are thinking that you want to make some changes and also you want to keep that previous route also, so you just rename it first. To rename it, click it over the name over here, and suppose we rename it like Tawau to Singapore AWPA. For viewer, VIEWER. After that, click outside and save it. After saving it, the previous route is still over there, and we are just making another route. And so that we can do any changes over here. So don't worry about that because the previous route is still over there. If you want, if you lose anything or you want to get some reference from the previous route, you can get it from there. Okay, let's start. So first we go to the general information. Here I just give the small familiarization tour over Navy Planner. What all things over here. Here I have the general information. Here I have the waypoints, and after that have schedule. After that you can put all those weather information, also get automatically also. After that, chart information, waypoint information, checklist, different checklist we can put, and also ADP ENP. After that, chart, this option no need for the route planning actually. And here we have route editor. In the route editor we have new, we can make new route by clicking on this option. After that, auto route, have load. By clicking load, we can take any previous route which one we already make or which one we already gone through in our because this ship is running for a long time, so normally it should be, we have too much route obviously, so all these routes are over here. After that, this focus button or focus option is very helpful for you. Suppose you are going over there by the cursor, you just click on the focus button so that you automatically come over your route. Then after that, have the waypoint editor. By the waypoint editor, you can edit any waypoint. Suppose after clicking waypoint editor, this cursor will come like that, and after that you can edit any waypoint. After that we have reference point. Reference point, normally we take from the from any fixed object, any landmark or any lighthouse or any, not actually from buoy or maybe from land, because the buoy also floating, so that's why we normally don't take reference point from the buoy. We normally take it from the fixed object, mostly from lighthouse or any beacon or land nearby. Suppose this can be a reference point. Also, you can think that in which direction you are putting this reference point. Like we are moving, we are going to from this direction to that direction, so that I make this reference point like this. Maybe we come out from this area to this area. Maybe we come out from this area to this area, that time we can make it like in 90 degree angle like this. So just now we making it like this, so that whenever we reach this point, that time we can understand that we need to alter our course. And also, and parallel indexing is also over there. I'll show you later on. After that, link option. By the link option, you can add any other route also. Suppose we have different discharge port, like in one discharge port we will not discharge the whole cargo. Maybe we have the different discharge port. We can link up the different route also for the next port. And also maybe for your passage plan, to make it easy, you can copy or link it up by the with the another route. After that, we have reverse option. In the reverse option, maybe in your load port and discharge port is if same, maybe for your reference only, you can make it like reverse option. You can use the reverse option. So that, but normally this one I use only for reference item, or not for actual passage plan, because if you reverse the passage plan, maybe so many things changes, because we are using different BTIS or different traffic circulation schemes. That time this traffic flow is not same. Either because you normally we use the starboard side traffic flow, so that when you come back, that time also you need to use the starboard side traffic flow. So it will not be same if you reverse the passage plan. After that, we have import option. We can import from any other file or any other. If you have suppose I am sign off from this ship, and maybe I'll go to the another ship. So I can copy all these waypoint which one I make over here. I can put it in my pen drive, and after that in my next ship I can use my own passage plan into that by importing over here from pen drive or any of my hard disk. I can import over here. After that, export also same goes to like this. I can export all this passage plan and all this information to any external drive for this. This option is available over, and also have delete option. Suppose your too many passage plan you already make, maybe your memory is full. Normally it not goes like that, but sometimes if you want to delete anything, we can delete it from here, just a small option. After that, we go to wider routing, and the wider routing have so many information. Just go one by one. It's not a very important, also important, but we normally take wider information directly from the SATC, from the NAPTEX, from the wider facsimile, and also from different website, and also from different ADP and ENP we using. So that normally we don't rely on ECDIS blindly for the wider information. Maybe we can put some limit, that how much limit we can, this ECDIS can give alarm, wind speed limit. Maybe if cross that limit, maybe any typhoon warning or something like that, that time you can put all this value over here. After that, anchor option also have different so many functions over here. How many meter length of your anchor, and how many cable you want to drop anchor. After dropping anchor, we can put all this information over here, and also have depth and safety margin and safety radius. It has some different calculation. Maybe in some other video I will show you about this calculation. After that, have this check route. This check route option, after I will show you during passage plan, that this check route option is very useful. Whenever after making any passage plan, we click on this button so that automatically check the route, so that any danger or anything, it comes automatically. Also, it is a must option to check the route by this by using this button. After that, we have voice plan. Same thing like this, delete all this option. After I'll show you checklist tools. After have print and report, protection control. Also here also have different option over here. Here is the transverse indicator. You can, by clicking on that, you can get all this shortcut key. After that, this one have some settings over here. Normally whenever we request any chart, request some chart from the passage plan, that time we check out these settings also. How much our margin, our as per our company policy, the margin is around 5 nautical mile from our route. And also have some default settings, safety contour, safety depth, and cross track error. Our safety contour, this default setting is around 30 meter, and also cross track error is around 0.10 nautical mile. Also have turn radius. So many options over here. So we don't dig up into the settings normally too much, because once we make it, for a long time. Normally we don't use that much. After that, have so many options over here. You can go one by one. This is scale, original scale, this zoom in and zoom out, and also come to the real position area, something like that. So let's go to the real passes plan area.